Greetings, my name is Avery, and this is the 8th episode of my tutorial series where we are making a game using C++ and SCL2. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to make a tiled map using tiles like this, and then drawing them out onto the screen like this, based on a map system where it uses coordinates, where the coordinates are just the number, and the number correlates to which position on the tile set it is, and then it renders it to the screen. So now that I show you guys what we're going to do, we're going to go ahead and get started. In the last episode, this is what we ended up with. Just this window with a text and an image and an animating character that you can switch animation cycles between. So in this episode, we're going to go ahead and strip out most of this stuff, because now that we know the main mechanics, we're going to actually reuse them to be the actual game, like, so we don't need like text and stuff. And the way our game is going to work is going to be a little bit different than this, so we're not actually going to be using this character either. Besides, we're going to be, I don't have a character to show you guys at this moment. I'm going to have it in the next video. For this video, like I said, we're going to be covering this how to do the tile map system, so we're not going to actually have a character. So we're going to go ahead and change some things. So in here, we can go ahead and delete this file. And then I also have a new font file, and it's going to be in the GitHub page, but it's called font.ttf, and it's actually going to be in the resources directory. Then we can go ahead and delete these two player images. So now in here, I'll just delete that as well. So now jumping into the code, we're going to change some things. So we can get rid of the idle shield, and get rid of the star. And now, and that's in the header file. Now in the game CPP file, we are going to also get rid of any references of the things we just deleted. So we'll get rid of the set current animation, get rid of that. Get rid of that. Now we can delete this player stuff. And now in here, I just want to change that to resources font. And now, down here, get rid of these keyboard presses, because we're not doing that right now. We'll just comment that out. And then get rid of this, get rid of that. You can just comment that out as well. And now let's add a few more variables that are going to be defined up front. So this one's just going to be the width. We'll just do 750, and we'll do a height of 500. So now in here, this is for the width and the height of the window. So you're gonna just do width, height. And the reason we're saving is because we use it in other places. So right here it's used. This is the background color. Okay, and now for the background color, it's just going to be a sky blue hex. So let's get an example from a website. So let's use this as our background color. So with what we have right now, let's just quickly check it out and compile it. So this is what we have. So now let's make it so we can load in a map file, and so we can just load it in and draw it. So we're going to need two functions. First one's going to be called loadMap. And in this, we'll just pass in the file, the map, so const a character, file name. And then we'll do a void drawMap. And now, let's just create these two functions. But before we leave, we're going to need to create a few more variables and include some libraries. So we're going to include the fstream library, which is going to be used for reading in a file, so we can read in our maps. And then we're also going to include a vector, which is what our map is going to be saved as. So right here, we'll just do vector object. So it's going to be a vector of objects, and we'll call it map. So it's as simple as that. So now, down here, we'll create these two functions. The draw map function will be very simple, so I'll just finish that. So it's just looping through the vector, and it just loops right through it, and then for every single piece, it'll draw it. So it's just going to do draw map I. Now let's go ahead and add that into the render function. So we'll just do draw map. And now up here, let's load in a map. So we'll just do load map, and the map will just be in the resources. We'll call 1.level. We'll create that file soon. Okay, so now in here, we want to make sure to say it's part of the game class. So now in here, you're going to have a few things. So we'll create a variable called current, a variable called mx and y, so those are the starting points in the map. So it doesn't have to be started at 0, 0. You can start off at a different point in the map. And then we'll have the width and the height of the map. So now we want to create a stream as well. So it's ifstream and then n. And we'll pass in the file name. So that's what using the fstream library does. So this basically just creates an object of the file called n, so like input. And now we can go through and loop through it and read it. But first thing you want to do is check if it opens. So if it didn't open, we'll just give it an error and let's say count failed to open map file. And then return. Okay, so now if we actually do open it, we'll loop through the file. So to do that, we're just going to have a loop through the width and the height. So it's looping through the height first. So int I equals 0, then I greater than height, then I plus plus. Now we'll do the same thing with a j for the width. So j equals width, and then j plus plus. Okay, so now that it's in there, you want to make sure it hasn't reached the end of the file. To do that, you just do if in.eof, and that means you can just say it finished a file too soon. So reached end of map file too soon. And let's return. So that means the file doesn't actually have as many blocks as it should. So now you want to do make sure, so the file, every single, I'll show you in the file, but basically there's going to be numbers for every single tile in the file. And if the number is 0, that means there's no tile in that object. So now we just want to check if it is not 0, and then we'll continue. So to set current to 0, you just do n current, and that'll read it. And then right up here to read and everything else, you're going to want to do n, and then mx, then n, actually it's going to be the width and height first, mny, or height, sorry, and then mx, n, my. So this is basically just reading in each variable individually, and this one is going to be looping through it so you can read it in. And you also want to close the file, so let's do n close, just so we don't forget about that. And it also reminds me, someone pointed this out, I forgot to do it. In the destructor, we want to close the actual font. Not just quit it, but also close the font that was created. Just so there's no like memory leak, so it doesn't have it open always. So I'll just close it that way. So back in here, now we want to loop through. And we're basically just going to have to create a new, a temporary object. So it's going to be object temp. And now we want to push that into the actual map. So it's going to push back and then temp. So the temp, you want to load in the image, and this we'll call it just tile set under the resources. It's going to be PNG, pass in the render. And now we want to set the source, and how the source will work is just the image, it's going to be one flat line of tiles, so it's going to be just current minus one times, and we'll create this new object in here, a new variable. Let's call it tile size. We'll set that to 25. So it's going to be times the tile size. We'll set that one to 0, and then the width and the height are going to be tile size as well. Now for the destination, it is going to be. So you're going to want to add the mx, and then my, and then tile size, and then I might have these flipped, so let's just do j times tile size, I times dial size. Okay, that's as simple as that. So now let's go ahead and create a file image for our map. So let's do new, and height will be 25. We'll set that to 100. So now in GIMP, after you created the file, we're going to want to configure a grid. You're going to set the grid to 25 by 25. Now in view, you do show grid, and now it splits up the tiles. We'll create another layer that's transparent, and we'll just hide this one. So now let's create our first tile. We'll just select this top grid right here, and now we'll just make it a light pink. And this first tile can just be for the walls of a building. And now the background walls of the building you can actually walk through. We'll just make it darker. And actually this will be the edges of a building walls. And now this one right here will be the interior of the walls. And now we'll also have a window. So the window will basically just be this one right here, but it'll be transparent. So let's move it over here, and then we'll just turn down the transparency. And now it'll blend in with whatever the background color is. We'll just save that as tile set. Now let's export it as well. And export. Alright. And now in here, we're going to create a new file. It's going to be the map. So it's going to be 1.level. So now, let's just fill in this like that. Let's create one more. And now, let's just say it's going to be width is 7, and there's going to be 5 height. So let's just do like so. And now let's give it the starting point of 100 and 200. And now let's set the bottom to 3, just for an example picture. So the bottom's all going to 3, and the house will be made out of 1. So we're just going to make a small building. And now let's fill in the building. So it's going to be 2. And the window can be 4. So one other thing we want to do is in the object class, we're going to make one other variable called the solid. And basically the solid just says if you can collide into the object or not. So I'll just do void set solid bool s, and then solid equals s, and then void get solid const return solid. So now we'll make it so it's by default it'll be solid. So solid equals s, or sorry, solid equals true. Okay, so now in here, it's going to be by default solid, but this one right 2 and 4, so this one right here and here, isn't going to be solid because you can actually walk through these because that's just background images. So we can just do if current equals 2 or current equals 4, and then temp.set solid equals false. And now this needs to be doubled like that. And now let's compile this. Alright. Void, okay, there's no return type for that. This right here needs to be a boolean. And 118. Return right there. That was, okay, so this one right here, we're at the end line. Alright, now let's try that out. Alright, and there we go. This is our image that we drew in. So as you can see, this right here is all threes. So then it takes a third one, it draws it out. So it's pretty simple. And this one's transparent, but it's transparent based on this color and the background color. So this is the width and the height. You can change this, and it'll change the layout, so let's do that. You don't have to recompile it, you just have to rerun it, and see it move the image. So that's pretty simple. This is just the way how we're going to be loading in our map. for our game. And in just a moment, I'm going to get back to you with a better drawing and a better way to render it in so we can have more complex maps. Alright, so now I got a level designed. It looks like this when it's done. This is the file for it. This is just the coordinates that it's set to. There could be a few mistakes with everything. I haven't made it so you can move around or anything, because we're going to be covering up that in the next video, along with collision and setting up a player. You can see right here, at least if you're using the Visual Code, Studio Code, you can see it's kind of like a, shows kind of the outline. I think Sublime and Atom probably has something like that too, because that's outline for code, but you can kind of see the design of the building just as is right there. It's a little bit more, we can't really stretch it out, but it's pretty simple. As you can see, it's like this. These are like windows, this is a building, there's elevators and outside doors and rooftops. This is the images. There's a lot more that I haven't actually used, because there's different layouts. For the main layout, it's just the pink one, but as you can see, there could be a blue and green one, but they're not designed for the actual building pieces, but that could be easily fixed. So this is just that end of it. So whenever you have this map right here, it's very large, so I'll take a moment to actually open up, but in the next video, whenever we cover how to actually draw, how to move around, we're going to make it so it only renders this, because we're going to be doing collision, so we're going to be able to make sure it only draws what's on the screen, so then it'll load a lot faster, and plus, we'll make it so once it loads the actual map, it'll load at the very beginning. And so it's a one-time load, and then also be like a main menu, so it'll be loading in the background, so it won't actually, you won't be able to tell. So that's enough for this video. Thanks again for watching. Like always, all the code and everything that we did is going to be linked in the description to the GitHub page, so you can go ahead in there, you can see the latest commit for this episode. If you guys are new here, if you haven't already, feel free to subscribe and go ahead and like the video. And if you want to know when the latest update's going to come out, you can go ahead and click the notification bell by the subscribe button. And also on the GitHub page, if you're following along with the code, just feel free to like star it on there as well, so you can get updates on when the code is new updated, because sometimes I'll update it before I actually upload the video. Thanks again for watching, and you guys have a great day. The bubble.